Gothenburg and neighborhood. It's a pleasure to be here, and you're going to tell a story. Ladies and gentlemen, the story we're going to tell started 10 years ago. I was walking on the street in Basel, a little town in Switzerland by the river, the corner of Switzerland, Germany and France. Some of you may know it, some of you may have passed it, some of you may have heard about it, and some of you, I don't know, maybe you don't know. That was a summer day. I was walking in and I saw some kids in a fountain. You know, in Basel we have fountains everywhere. You can drink the water, and if it is warm, you can jump in the water and make yourself cool. Take the edge off the temperature. Playing around, doing water fight, laughing. I went to them and I asked them, "Who are you kids? Do you have permission from your parents? Why are you so happy? Don't you know that the future is a kind of shaky? It's called the shadow of future." And the kids, they were okay, they were happy. It was all fun. And yes, they had permission. State of mind. I want to play around in a fountain too. I want to have a smile and laughter and stupid stuff. Journey began 10 years ago. I prepared myself, got a haircut first. Went to the doctor. Got home packed. couple of t-shirts and a warm hat. And I hit the road. I started north. Ended up in a city where the directions don't exist. I had my map and I wanted to go from A to B, but I ended up in D or C or F. Languages acted differently than I was expecting them to do. And they didn't smile. I learned a thing though. That the directions north, south, east, west don't really exist. There are more to that. Turned around 5 times, stopped at the direction, and I kept on walking. Got to a hill with a little town on top of that hill, ruled by a king, married to the queen, had a prince who was totally nuts, and a beautiful princess. I entered the town, and I asked people, what is this town? What is this town? They said, here you can see ghosts. You go up in the tower at night and you see the lights. The lights you see moving, these are ghosts. I got a little afraid first. Because I'm not, first of all, I don't really believe in ghosts. And if they are, I don't know if they are friendly or not. Maybe they want to do me something. But the temptation was there. Till it get dark. Silence captured the town. Shadows were dancing. Mm. followed them. At the top of the mountain, I saw the lights, the stars, the shooting stars. They came and they left. Right now I saw a deer outside. That was something like that. I just saw it. It was there. Moved and disappeared. I must admit that sometimes I have tendencies to meditate. And by meditation I mean I sit somewhere and I do absolutely nothing. I let the time pass by. I let the thoughts just come in and go, you know, usual meditation kind of thinking. And there, at a point, I could see that these lights, they were coming to me, and I got afraid. And when I get afraid, I drink. What my mother told me, and I'm gonna tell it to you. Stay away from drugs, stay away from alcohol, shady ladies and dubious friends. Don't interact with that. Know where you are, know where you wanna go, and find the shortest way. That's mathematics for you. Once the lights cut in, the bottles start to arrive. I opened the first one, drank it all in one, and suddenly I could see the lights, you know, kind of. Changing color. Maybe that was a flashback. God, I've been a bad boy. I've done other stuff. Run! No direction. Sometimes down, sometimes up, sometimes round and round. Sometimes up, sometimes down, sometimes round and round. I got dizzy. Start to have a headache. Luggage getting heavier. Fever coming to me and felt my eyes burning. I had to go. Ran away. Hide. You have three options. You can stay and fight. You can run and hide. Or you can stay and fight. The chicken that I am, I started to run. temptations come when you want to go from A to B. And then the temptations are the tours. There is something there, and we all get tempted by something. Some got tempted by power, some get tempted by money, some by beauty, some by I don't know. I knew a friend of mine who got tempted by love. Another friend of mine get tempted by the idea. The perfect place the utopia is? And she said, no, but that sounds fun. Let's go. And we walked. Mm-hmm. just have to keep on doing whatever you're gonna do in order to find out what it is you're going to do. He walked through snow. He walked through the desert. We climbed mountains. We slept on beaches. And then we got to this other place. Buildings 13, 17. The newest one was 14, 28. Small shops, small people, dressed kind of greenish with a hat. And we walked, and we could see stuff. A guy who was planting a rose. A lady buying some eggs. Neighbors fighting over the noise. Why the hell are you playing so loud all the time? Karin, do you make any sense of all this place? Brother Henrik was somewhere doing something, but he looked friendly. Looked like we were, or he was open for conversation. We went to Henrik. He said, "You see all these people, what are they doing?" Well, this town is also a magical little town. Everything that has happened since 1317 and 1482, they are still happening. And the guy who was planting the rose, he started that 700 years ago, and he's still planting that rose. Fighting nevers, they're still fighting. The lady with the eggs. You can go touch them. You can go interact with them. And if you do, you end up in that timeline. Drunk to sing, the bartender was too stoned to serve, the guy, he was confused, so he looked at me and said, what do you want? I said, I want to go back, I want to go somewhere, you know, we are here, we got by accident, we got here, and we just have to get somewhere, because I promised, I have this intention of getting to place where I belong, where I am happy. And there, I can play in the motherfucking fountain. Like the kids. Time had passed by. It was like 10 years ago. Thank you. into the city. I was a little bit tipsy. Henrik was talking about going home. Karin said maybe there is some other temptation around the corner. Maybe we could find somewhere else. We decided to continue. To go to that place, wherever that place said come to me. So that's what we did. There was a lake, a couple of mountains, some palm trees, benches by the shore, a little bar serving frozen margaritas. Maybe we want to go there. Who would say no to a beach holiday, a permanent vacation in a good weather, 28 degrees, with a breeze? Harmony, beauty, relaxation. Stars. we all went to that little town. But that was not the right place either. No. It was too crowded somehow. By emptiness. We decided to go further away. And that's the point where I got tired. I said, you know what? The promise, the idea of finding my place, I'm getting tired. I've been on the fucking road for, what, 8-9 years? And I still haven't found what I'm looking for. There's a song to that even. Fuck it. I don't want to be happy. I don't want to play in no motherfucking fountain. Let the kids have their fun. Me, I'm gonna settle down by the stones and by water. Stones giving stability, making it heavy. Planted, rooted, huge stones. You have to drill the motherfucker. Use dynamite with the huge bang. Just to scratch a bit of it. And the water controls everything. The wind. The cold. The rain. I'm sure you know this place. It is somewhere north in a little kingdom, not that little, but still a kingdom, called Sweden. The little place, which is not that little, but is still a place, is called Gothenburg. We ended up here with you wonderful people. So now I have to ask, is this the right place?
Yes. Yes.
Is it?
Yes.
Yes.
Do we like to be here?
Yes.
Do we enjoy the beautiful weather? Even if it is cold,
yes.
Even if it is rainy,
yes.
The wind.
Yes.
So what do we do when we are here?
We enjoy it.
Let the kids play what they do. Let the fairy tales end as they do. Let the temptation lead your way. I am tired now. I have maybe one corner to turn, one page to write, one song to sing. I'm pretty sure that there are tons of whiskey bottles waiting for me to kill them! And that's what I'm gonna do. The good news is that Christmas is getting closer. It's gonna be nice. The darkest night is almost over. The light is gonna shine brighter.